How do you do something that's really tough? How do you do something that your body really doesn't want to do? Why should you give up sugar? Sugar is pure energy. Our body craves it. Why would you want to give that up? I'm Samir, and I'm a health coach and an anthropologist based in Johannesburg. And today we're going to get into all of these questions and more. So for starters, let me say that this is day three of my personal No Sugar November challenge. If you'd like to join me on this challenge, there's a link below to sign up. You'll get some information on what the challenge means and how you can tailor it for your needs. There's also a link below to my new book, The Health Dialectic, which has gotten some great reviews. I'll also post a link to the Goodreads page for it, so you can see I'm really touched by all the positive reviews that this is getting. If you've read it, please do leave a review. And if you haven't read it, well, what are you waiting for? Yeah. How is this no sugar challenge going for me? It has definitely not been easy, right? But of course, I wasn't expecting it to. The first day was basically a lot of craving. I had hoped, so I have a trick when I'm doing this kind of change, I generally extend my fasting window. So for me, it's a lot easier as a rule just not to eat at all than to not eat certain things, right? So for me, I was planning to do a 24 or maybe even a 36-hour fast. It just didn't end up working out for whatever reason. I ended up eating it at around lunchtime, which translates to a typical 16, 17-hour fast for me. That's what I do most days. And then after I ate, I started feeling the usual cravings for something sweet, right? So, you know, usually I would go for a piece of dark chocolate, or I'd go for a piece, a dried date, or maybe some blueberries and cream or something. But instead of giving into those cravings, so I was craving all those things, instead of giving into those cravings, I just made myself busy. And it happens that Monday was an extremely busy day for me. So, you know, that sort of the busyness related to work and so on, that just sort of took over, and I didn't give in to the cravings at the end. On Tuesday, so that was yesterday, day two, the cravings were a little bit less. And today, on Wednesday, day three, the cravings are even less. But they're still kind of there, you know, and I'm hoping that my body will stop giving me these cravings in another day or two. At least that's what most people who've done this kind of thing, that's what they describe, that by day five, you're really not feeling the kind of cravings that you felt on day one. Now, just to recap some of the information you'll see if you sign up below, I'm doing a particularly hardcore version of the No Sugar Challenge. So no sugar, no sweeteners, no fruit, no milk, because milk has lactose, which is a sugar. But you don't have to do it the same way. If you want to join, you can do it at whatever level you want to. Maybe you just want to cut out sugar and use stevia, monk fruit, other low-carb sweeteners. That's fine. Maybe you want to keep some of the less sugary fruits in, like berries, maybe an apple. That is totally fine. It's totally up to you. Why am I doing this? Well, as I posted elsewhere and I've talked about a lot, sugars, especially table sugar, which is half fructose and half sucrose is half fructose and half glucose, is an extremely toxic substance. And the fructose especially is quite problematic. So there are all kinds of health reasons to get sugar out of your life. But you could do that, and I have done that in the past, by relying on artificial sweeteners. So this time I wanted to do it, but in a way that really addressed the root of my problem, which is my addiction to sweets. I've had a sweet tooth most of my life. You know, if you have a sweet tooth, if you crave certain foods, you have a choice. Either you can get rid of that craving, or you're going to have to give in to that craving every single day, right? And that craving then becomes a kind of a prison. And I, you know, believe me, after a couple of days of not having sweets, I know the extent to which I was living in a prison. So for me, this is very important just to prove that I can do it, to prove that I'm not addicted, to prove that I can get over whatever bad habits I might have. It's not easy. It's possibly the most difficult thing I've had to do since I gave up cigarette smoking some time ago. So with that, I'm Samir, and I'm your health coach and an anthropologist based in Johannesburg. The link is below if you want to see the full video explaining what the challenge is and how to participate. And please do remember to like and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you next time.